Everything is like $3 or $4 more than originally priced.
I go and get my dog food and it went up, 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 up.
Some days I just like don't eat because I know that the next day or the next paycheck, I can eat then. Yeah, dollar pizza, where'd it go?
All of the inflation metrics are running well above the Fed's target now.
You know, if an inflation's an elevator, you know, we went up to the 20th floor, but we're not going all the way back down to the first. We're going, you know, somewhere to like the fifth floor here. In other words, inflation's going to remain elevated relative to the Fed's target.
Inflation ran 7.7% higher in October of 2022 compared with the year earlier. That was slightly less than forecast and a small sign that inflation could be slowing. Roughly speaking, something that would have cost a dollar in 2021 now costs nearly $1.08 today. But the prices for certain everyday goods are skyrocketing. Egg prices are up 43% compared with a year ago, while butter is up almost 34% and public transit is up 28%, just to name a few.
Most of the economists that I speak to think that inflation is going to begin to really start to calm down next year. These long and variable policy lags will start to kick in. The interest rates will start to slow the economy notably.
It's probably going to be lower next year. How much lower is, you know, we're not quite sure. Inflation can be very hard to predict, especially on the headline, because as economists say, unexpected developments happen. We call these shocks, and the models can't predict the shocks, nor can we.
Overall, we think core inflation is going to remain sticky at these elevated levels, but that's despite the fact that you are probably going to get some moderation. So it's not going to stay at 6. It's probably going to go down to something like 4, but 4 is still well above the, you know, the Federal Reserve's 2% longer-term inflation target.
So we're forecasting inflation to fall to 2.6% for 2023. In terms of the full year average, and then 1.4% in 2024. Now, consensus is also expecting inflation to come down, but we're expecting it to come down even faster. And I think the biggest reason for our optimism is the unwinding of these supply side shocks that have pushed up inflation over the last several years.
So what we see is that inflation will be about 6% in 2022, but it will be about 3% for 2023. And so even though the Fed is raising interest rates and it should peak close to 5% in the Fed funds rate, that will not allow the economy just to hockey stick back. So it is going to remain sluggish through the balance of 2023 and into 2024.
One tool the Federal Reserve has to dampen inflation is what's known as the federal funds rate. That's the rate at which big commercial banks charge to lend money to each other on an overnight basis. The federal funds rate influences the cost of borrowing throughout the entire economy, from mortgages to credit cards to large-scale capital investments. That rate has largely remained near zero since the 2008 Great Recession, but this year, the central bank has moved at a historic pace to increase that rate in hopes of cooling down a hot economy and slowing inflation. In November, the Fed increased the Fed funds rate by 75 basis points, marking its sixth consecutive rate hike.
My colleagues and I are strongly committed to bringing inflation back down to our 2% goal. We have both the tools that we need and the resolve it will take to restore price stability on behalf of American families and businesses.
The worry about where the Fed is taking us is that they keep enacting these 3/4-point rate hikes without taking the time to see what the long-term impact of them is going to be. And then we get to this point where later on down the road, it's like, wow, all this stuff starts to kick in, the economy really starts to slow, and we're not able to achieve what the Fed is looking for, what they call a soft landing economically.
Remember, the Fed has been very clear that they are willing to impose the pain on the economy, meaning the recession and potentially a hit to jobs down the road, in order to tame inflation, and they want to hit a long-term rate of 2%. So we don't see that happening until 2024, and so our expectations are that the Fed will raise rates, that it should be close to 5%.
I think clearly what the Fed is trying to convey is that, you know, achieving price stability is something we're going to do, or at least going to try to do to the best of our ability. And now what that means in terms of the policy rate, it's unclear. Obviously, markets are expecting maybe something above 5%. I've been forecasting a long time, and one of the things you want to try to do is keep your options open when there's a period of high uncertainty.
We do think you are probably going to see a recession in 2023 as a result of what the Fed, not only the Fed, but other central banks have done to tighten financial conditions. But nevertheless, you know, I think that is the necessary evil here. The recession is a necessary evil to really bring down inflation.
We happen to think that if there is a recession in the U.S. economy, that it will be a mild and short-lived recession, which is not what we associate the term recession with in our memory, because our historical memory is dominated by, you know, the sharp fall in GDP during the pandemic, but even more so than that, the Great Recession, which was not only severe, but very long-lasting.
This could be a relatively job-full recession. Most recessions cause pain in the job markets as people then experience layoffs and, you know, they're thrown out of work. In this case, with 10 million job openings going into a recession, and it's an employee's market here, wages are rising quite rapidly, this could be a much less painful experience with the Fed trying to tame inflation than it has been in the past.
We're used to this counter-cyclical policy response. So the Federal Reserve, whenever they see weakness in growth, dropping the Fed funds rate, or fiscal policymakers, you know, providing more economic stimulus. And as a result of elevated inflation, we're probably not going to get that this time. So what you're going to have is, you know, maybe the U.S. economy emerges from recession later in 2023, but when it emerges, it's still going to be sluggish and below trend growth that it comes out of it too.
How deep that recession goes, how deep the slowdown is really hard to call right now. But as far as economists go, I think the general expectation is not a drastic recession and inflation slowing, but that's a lot of things have to go right for that to happen, and it's unclear whether those things will in fact fall into place the way that a lot of folks hope they will.
If you see a couple good inflation numbers and you assume, well, this is the start of a long march towards 2%, I think, you know, history tells us that we need to be very diligent in making sure that this deceleration in inflation, if it's ongoing, is going to persist.